double field revolving wheel. Okay, so in this double field revolving field theory, so there are two types of alternating quantities. Okay, so by taking two types of alternating quantity, so you have to explain can easily understand this concept of double field. Okay, in double field revolving theory states that any alternating quantity, okay, alternating flux, here alternating flux, any alternating quantity means like, so in this single phase induction motor we have to consider an alternating flux. Okay, can be resolved into two components having magnitude half of the maximum magnitude, so pi m by 2. Pi m is called half of the, and then pi m is called maximum value of flux. Okay, pi m by 2 is called half of the maximum magnitude of the alternating quantity, and both these components are rotating in opposite direction. Okay, so in double field revolving theory, alternating quantity can be resolved into two components. Okay, it's having some half of the magnitude, half of the maximum magnitude of alternating quantity. That's called pi m by 2, pi m by 2. Here is called pi m. This is called maximum value of alternating quantity. This can be resolved into two components. One is called pi m by 2 and another is called pi m by 2, half of the. Okay, so about rotating opposite direction. So one is rotating, this is called A vector. So this is called B vector. This A vector is rotating in this direction, the magnitude of pi m by 2, and B vector is also rotating anti-clockwise direction. Clockwise direction, okay, with the magnitude of pi m by 2. So equal in magnitudes. Okay. That's it. So equal in magnitude, but opposite directions. One vector is rotating in this direction, another vector is rotating in this direction. The alternating quantity can be divided into two vectors. That is called A vector and B vector. The A vector magnitude is called pi m by 2, and B vector is magnitude is called pi m by 2. It is rotating. A vector is rotating in counterclockwise direction, and B vector is rotating in clockwise direction. The driving magnitude is pi m by 2, and A vector is driving magnitude is pi m by 2. Okay. So from this, I guess you can easily understand the double field revolving theory. First, so we can why single phase induction motor is not system. So we have to consider why single phase induction motor is not self-starting, and also how to make the single phase induction motor self-starting. Understood. So here, this pi m by 2 is rotating in this direction, and this fellow in this direction. Okay, so this is the position. At this position, the resultant magnetic flux is called pi m by 2, pi m by 2. Okay, then total pi m. All right? This, and this is having some angle. Okay, and is rotating in this direction, on the counterclockwise direction, and is rotating in this. The resultant of these two is called pi m. Okay. The resultant of these two is called addition of these two is called pi m. And they coming here, this is a alternating magnitude of pi m by 2, okay, is exactly opposite each other. They are this instant. At this instant, okay, the flux is developed on one side of this rotor, so like this, another side is because of one half cycle, this flux developed in one side, and because of another half cycle, the flux is in the opposite direction. Alternating quantities. Okay. So this at this position, pi m by 2 and pi m by 2. So this is called exactly opposite two vectors. That's why what is the resultant flux in this rotor? Zero. Okay, that's called pi m by 2. And similarly in this direction, the resultant is called like this. And then finally, so we'll get this. It's called pi m by 2 and it is also pi m by 2. Then resultant is called. So like this, alternating quantities and single phase induction motors. Okay, and then so first, why single phase induction motor is not self-starting? So this stator of a single phase induction motor is wound with the single phase winding. Clear? Stator of a single phase induction motor is worn with single phase mining. But in a three phase mining, three phases are phase, three phase. But in here only single phase mining. Either R phase or Y phase or three phase. Any one of them. Not three. Only one. Okay. So when this stator is fed with the single phase supply, it produces alternating flux. Okay, which alternates along one space axis only. Okay. When the stator is fed with the single phase supply, it produces alternating flux. Which alternates along one space axis only. Okay. Alternating flux acting on a squirrel cage induction motor cannot produce the rotation, only revolving flux. Here, because of single phase supply, is not true. It is called rotating flux is absent. Rotating flux is absent in a single phase induction motor in stator, right? So only alternating flux is there. Okay. So only revolving flux can be. This cannot produce the rotation. Only revolving flux can produce. That's why the single phase induction motor is not self-starting. Because of the rotating, so main concept is there is absence of rotating magnetic field because of that rotor is not rotating. Okay, and also the resultant torque on this squirrel cage induction motor, the resultant torque acting on the rotor is equal to zero. Okay, one torque acting on another one direction, another torque acting as another direction. Okay, forward torque and backward torque. Because of this, A vector. One torque is developed. That is called forward torque. Because of the B vector, backward torque is developed. These two torques. So here, these two torques are exactly opposite. Forward torque and backward torque. So then resultant torque acting on the rotor is equal to zero. And then the single phase induction motor is not rotating. And this, so this way, this rotor is not rotating in a single phase induction. So that's why starting winding is required in a single phase induction. So then how to make the, okay,